wire helped revolutionize the West by dividing up the land evenly and cheaply. However, some people out west found it to be an impediment to moving across wide plains. Cowboys and Native Americans even came up with a new name for it, Devil's Rope. Joseph Farewell Glidden was a very influential man in the creation of barbed wire, and he forever changed the West and the world. Barbed wire helped reform the West, but it had to start somewhere. Joseph Glidden saw a wire attachment at the DeKalb County Fair presented by Henry M. Rose. He used a wood rail and hammered nails into it to hook onto a wire fence. Joseph Glidden was there with Jacob Haish and Isaac Elwood. They each saw this and began to talk to Henry about it. Joseph went home and began to invent to improve what he saw at the fair that day. Joseph began to hear his wife Lucinda complain that this one cow named Brindle kept getting through the fence. Joseph heard of this complaint, and he remembered of the wire attachment he saw at the DeKalb County Fair. His imagination grew, and he soon had an idea that would forever change the world. Shortly after complaining of the animals getting into the yard, Lucinda had something else to complain about. Little by little, every night, her hairpins began disappearing. She blamed her daughter Elva, but she was not the thief. She figured it out when she saw Joseph with the hairpins in his pocket. Joseph took those hairpins to his workshop, and he used a coffee grinder to twist them into barbs. The question that remains to be answered was how to secure the barbs. Joseph wanted a simple and cheap way to make the barbs stay in place. The solution was to twist two long lengths of wire together. This made it so the barbs would not twist and bend as the animals crashed into the fence. The next step was to make the barbed wire become popular, and that had to start with partnering with a manufacturer. That manufacturer was Washburn and Moan. Washburn and Moan were out visiting DeKalb, Illinois, for barbed wire, and they wanted to partner up with Glidden in his productions. Glidden was unsure about this, and he consulted a lawyer about it. The lawyer said to go for it, but keep the royalties so he could continue to make money. Joseph signed the contract, and they went into business together. Isaac Elwood created a wire that had mangled metal pieces sticking out of it. One day, Elwood and his wife were riding by Glidden's farm, and Elwood's wife said that Glidden had a better barbed wire design than he did. Consequently, it was a quiet ride home. Jacob Haish built a barbed wire, and it was very popular, as well as Glidden's. It was referred to as the S-barb. The barb was twisted around two wrapped wires to hold it in place, just like Glidden's. Isaac Elwood partnered up with Glidden so that he could monopolize the barbed wire industry and focus on the business aspect. Part of the reason he partnered with Glidden was because of his wife's opinion. Haish was a fierce competitor, and he went to court to see who got the patent that Glidden eventually won. A factory was set up in DeKalb, Illinois, to manufacture the barbed wire in. Barbed wire was constantly made, and it was easier and cheaper to manufacture it nearby and send it off. Glidden could easily check up on his productions without traveling for days at a time. Joseph Glidden had patents already, so when he saw the barbed wire, he thought that he could make that, so he did. He was a very creative man, and he was intelligent too. Before Joseph invented barbed wire, he invented something called the land roller. It had wheels placed in special alignment, so they did not go over the same land twice. Barbed wire was needed out west, and Glidden's barb was easy to transport, so it went west. The wire migrated west because of the Texas longhorn cattle. They would trample and graze on the farmers' crops, and the farmers hated it. Cattle would also get run over by the trains, because they would cross in front of a train on the newly built Transcontinental Railroad. Barbed wire was put up to line the railways for miles at a time. Some people, like cattle drivers and Native Americans, hated barbed wire so much that they came up with a new name, Devil's Rope. The cattle drivers and Native Americans needed wide open spaces for their travel, and they couldn't have barbed wire blocking their way. The cattle drivers needed this space to corral and push the Texas Longhorns across the plains. Native Americans hunted buffalo, and they needed space to travel with them, and barbed wire was just sitting there. They couldn't go through. No Google Maps were around to look at the alternate route around the barbed wire. It was a pain to find ways around the mess, and that was when the barbed wire wars were started. Barbed wire wars divided the West. It was the people who loved barbed wire and thought it was incredibly useful, like the farmers, versus the people who thought that barbed wire was the worst plague that ever came upon our nation, like the Native Americans and the cowboys. The haters of barbed wire would go out during the night in masks and cloaks to hide their identity and cut barbed wire fences, as well as vandalize, trespass, and set ablaze farmers' fences and land. People out west formed groups where they would go out together and terrorize. Some of the group's names were Owls, Javelinas, and the Blue Devils. It was estimated that the damages in the wars alone resulted in being around $20 million. It even came to the point where 3 to 7 homicides were committed in times where the two sides confronted each other. Yes, barbed wire has had a rough history, but it really just depends on your perspective. Was barbed wire useful or not? The barbed wire span, starting when Joseph invented his barbed wire to when he sold the company, lasted under 10 years. Joseph Farewell Glidden sold his company to Isaac Elwood, and Elwood continued to produce his product. Joseph Glidden became a very successful man at some point in his life. His occupations were a banker, a businessman, city developer, county supervisor, entrepreneur, farmer, hotel keeper, inventor, mayor, philanthropist, newspaper publisher, rancher, sheriff, and teacher. On top of doing all of these occupations, Glidden used his money for good. He earned so much from all that he did. He was able to donate so much back to the community. NIU, or otherwise known as Northern Illinois University, would not be in DeKalb, Illinois if not for Joseph Glidden. He donated his 600 acres for the school property. Everyone also called him Uncle Joe because he knew everyone, and the people would strike up a conversation with him as if he weren't this incredibly prosperous man. Today, barbed wire has been used in wars, barricades, barracks, concentration camps, and even home decorations. Joseph Farewell Glidden cut through the country with his patented barbed wire. He will forever be remembered in DeKalb County as Uncle Joe, the man who reshaped the West.